If you've ever started to notice that something's not right down there, then you're definitely not alone. In fact, 3 in 4 women will have a yeast infection at some point in their life, and at least half of these women will have recurrent yeast infections throughout their lifetime. Welcome to Yeast Infections Debunked. In this video, we'll be following the story of Sarah, who confides in her friend about an infection she thinks she has and goes to the doctor for a diagnosis. So I've been having some really weird discharge, itchiness, and swelling down there, and I was just wondering what you think I should do.
I think you should go see a doctor.
Hi, Sarah. How are you? So tell me what's wrong.
So the past couple days, I've noticed that I have some swelling, weird discharge, and extreme itchiness, and I'm getting a little bit concerned.
Yeah, that is concerning, actually. Okay, so I'm gonna need you to do a pelvic exam and a vaginal swab. I will call you once we have the results back. Hi, Sarah. I just wanted you to come in to let you know that you tested positive for a yeast infection.
Oh no, what is that? What am I supposed to do?
This is an infection of the vagina that causes itching and burning of the vulva and area around the vagina. This is caused by an overgrowth of fungus. Your vagina usually has very small amounts of yeast, but when you have too much, that's when you get the infection. Things that increase the chances of you getting a yeast infection are hormonal, contraceptive, antibiotics, a weak immune system, being pregnant. But the most common symptoms are odorless, thick white discharge, and extreme itchiness in and around the vagina.
How am I supposed to treat it? Is it something permanent, or can I take medicine to make me feel better?
Yeast infections are treated with antifungal medication that can be taken orally or inserted as a cream. Short-term cases are treated with pills, creams, tablets, and more. Severe yeast infections are treated with antifungal medication taken daily for 2 to 6 months. Also, there is a therapy called azole-resistant therapy. Here, boric acid is inserted. This medication is dangerous if taken orally and is only used to treat a certain fungus that is resistant to the usual antifungal agents. With that said, since it's your first time getting this infection, I will prescribe you a single dose antifungal pill as well as some cream to be inserted.
Thank you so much. You made me feel so much better and less scared. But just so I know, how can I prevent this in the future?
I'm glad you asked. Some ways to prevent yeast infections are avoiding douching, as this removes fighting bacteria from the vagina. Avoiding scented products. Avoid wearing wet swimsuits and bathing suits for a long time. Also, you should wear cotton underwear to allow your vagina to breathe. Change your tampons and pads often. And just so you know, this is a common infection. Not only females get it, but males do as well. Also, I just want you to know that yeast infections cannot be treated with garlic or yogurt, because some people think they do, when in reality they don't.
Thank you so much for all your help today.
So in conclusion, a yeast infection is not something to be scared about. They are very treatable and you have many options, but always be sure to consult your doctor if you suspect you have one.